In this illustration, we'll analyze the interaction force between fission fragments. Here we are given that in the fission of plutonium by a thermal neutron, two fission fragments of equal masses and sizes are produced and four neutrons are emitted. We are required to find the force between the two fission fragments as they are produced. Fermi constant value is given to us. Here, if we write the nuclear reaction for the fission process, so nuclear reaction can be written as this plutonium-239, when a thermal neutron is fired onto it, 0 and 1, it creates an element X, so which is an excited state with the nuclear charge 94 and mass 240. And this excited nucleus will further decay to two identical fragments, which we are considering as Y, with the nuclear charge 47. And we can take nuclear masses to be the mass 240 minus 4 by 2, that is 118, as we are given that four neutrons are also emitted in the process. Now, in this situation, we are required to find the interaction force between these two daughter nuclei Y, which are produced as a result of fission of this plutonium nuclei. Now, in this situation, we can directly calculate first the charge on each Y is. We can see the nuclear charge is 47, so it is 47 multiplied by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So this numerical value is 7.52 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 18 coulomb. We can also calculate the radius of each Y, which can be given as R is equals to R naught A to power 1 by 3. And the value of R naught we are provided with 1.1 into 10 to power minus 15 multiplied by the atomic mass number of Y, we can take as 118 to power 1 by 3. On simplifying, this will give us a value 5.395 into 10 to power minus 15 meter. So, we have the radius of Y and the charge on Y. So, we can say when these two Y are produced, these are in this fashion, they would be almost touching each other when the fission take place. So, in this situation, the separation between the two fragments can be taken as twice the radius. So, we can write at the time two Y are produced, their separation is, this L can be written as 2R, which is equals to R we are already having. If we twice it, this will be 10.79 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 15 meter. Now we can calculate the force between these nuclei of Y is, this force we can give by Coulomb's law, which is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q square by L square. So we can substitute the numerical values, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught in SI units is 9 into 10 to the power 9 multiplied by Q square is 7.52 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 18 whole square divided by L square is 10.79 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 15 whole square. On simplifying this, the final value of force we are getting is 4.37 into 10 to the power 3 newton, or it is 4.37 kilonewton. This will be the final result of this problem.